Hi, this is Bob Johnson at Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff. And today, welcome back, by the way. And today we're going to talk about the Panasonic Toughbook CF-27. That's right, the legacy CF-27. What a workhorse this unit was. I don't know if you recall, but if you've watched the episode, and I'm going to put the link in here, for the Panasonic Toughbook CF-25 that we talked about. The CF-25, this is the next version of their fully rugged line of laptops. CF-27 comes with a nice handle. It was high tech at the time that it was made. I would imagine it was around 1999, 2000 that this model came out. The CF-27 weighs in at 8.5 pounds. So the CF-27, to start out with, weighs in at 8.5 pounds. It is a heavy laptop, but not as heavy as the CF-25, if you recall. This particular model is a P2300 megahertz. Notice I said megahertz and not gigahertz. So it's a third, a little less than a third of a gigahertz. The model I have sitting here is in great condition. I mean, when we got this in, I put it on the side just to put in our, what I call museum of Toughbooks. But you'll notice here, this came with the rubber keyboard so that you could actually spill water on this without it even affecting the system board at all. It slides right off. Interesting about this rubber keyboard versus the rubber keyboards of future models is this one has very defined keys. They're very defined and easy to type with. I believe this rubber keyboard is actually easier to type on than the future models that they created the rubber keyboard for. Well, the future models, the rubber keyboard is flatter and not as defined as this particular one is. This P2300 CF-27 also has a touchscreen, and it was fantastic at the time it was made, but by today's standards, it's very, very difficult to use. This CF-27 had some cool features at the time. If you look right here, the doors, I'm gonna open them up. This one right here, this is the coolest feature, was the PCMCI slots. Take a look at this. This is how you got wired Ethernet on your machine. Used a Zircom Ethernet card. This happens to be the real port Ethernet 10100 card. That's right, we love these cards because we could plug right into the network. It's a type 2 card because it takes up both slots, just like this. You can also get that card in a combo 56K modem, 10100 Ethernet, so you had two ports here. So that is the PCMCI slots. If you look on this side, it does have a multi-bay port, multi-bay slot, I'll call it. This particular one has the CD-ROM in it. They also made the high-tech 1.44 meg floppy disk drive for it as well. So I know you guys are excited about that. But if you pop this open, you just push this little button like that and out pops the CD-ROM drive. So you could put, they also made for this model as well, they also made a secondary battery that you could slide in here as well. It looks similar to this, but it was just contained a battery. So I'll put it back in, and then that door is sealed. And then on the back, I'll tell you something that came out on the 27 that was one of the first in the rugged time, and I guess it was based on the time frame, but look at that, USB port. It had one USB port. That was phenomenal. This machine came with Windows 98. You could upgrade and load Windows 2000 on it, and this particular one I see the licensing is Windows 2000 Professional. But not only do you have USB, but it had the external keyboard PS2 mouse. So you could put a PS2 mouse or keyboard on here. It has the standard mic and headphone jacks. And here's your docking station port. It has the SVGA external monitor, and the high-tech 25-pin parallel port so that you could connect your printer to it. And the standard age-old 9-pin serial port, which I'll remind you, Panasonic has kept on their models as they've gotten newer. So even the latest include the 9-pin serial port. That's for all that legacy equipment that they support. To upgrade the memory, now I'll tell you about the memory. This unit could maximize the memory on this unit to 192 meg. It came with 64 meg on board, on the system board, soldered on. There were slots to upgrade it with 128 meg of more memory. So you could get a total of 192 meg. Now notice I didn't say gig, I said meg. That's a fifth of a gig of memory. So, but at the time, that was fantastic, and Windows 98 loved all that memory. Another nice feature about this laptop, which I find fantastic, is the battery. The battery, brand new, would last 4.5 hours. That's 4.5 hours of battery life. That's just phenomenal. Even by today's standards, the laptops the ruggedized units, to last 4.5 hours, they didn't get much better than that. Now they're what, 8 hours? If they're brand new and you're using them under certain conditions. So I want to remind you today, we're talking about the CF-27. And the last item I want to talk about is screen resolution. On the CF-27, it could support three different resolutions. 640 by 480 resolution. High resolution at the time. 640 by 480. It also supported 800 by 600 resolution, as well as 1024 by 768 as well. So you were able to do three different resolutions using this laptop. Well, that's all I got on the CF-27. Don't forget to leave me a comment. Hey, if you got one of these, leave me a comment in the comment section so I know, so that I can see how many people actually still have these in their inventory. Don't forget to hit the like button as well, and the bell so you can sign up and we can notify you every time we post a new video. Typically, we post these episodes every Wednesday morning at 11. We also post repair videos every Tuesday morning at 11. So keep online, watch our episodes, and I want to thank you for watching today. Again, I'm Bob Johnson, Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff.